Welcome to the Django project, DJ Blogger. This tutorial is part of a YouTube Django project playlist, which you can access in the video description. You can watch the whole course from the very beginning. If you enjoy this course and would like all the updated tutorials and associated code samples and more, you can check out this course and other courses this project features at Udemy. The link to the course is in the video description. Let's now finish off the post content. So we're going to need to create some styling here. You can see that it's very much central and pretty much all the time. Let's just zoom in and take a look at the behavior at the smaller size. So you can see that we have retain a padding on the left and right hand side. And you can see that when the right bar disappears, we still have this central aligned, and you can see there is a maximum size, it looks like, for this text. And you can see that the text does also scale down. Right, so let's see if we can build that. This is where we start from. So back in our code, let's just close down everything and we'll start fresh. This is where we left off in the previous tutorial. So let's go into the blogger, DJ blogger templates. We're working on the single template. This is where we have all the content at the moment. Let's start off by wrapping everything we've got here. Now remember, we need to be inside the middle block. So let's wrap all this up inside of a div, and then we're going to create a new class here. This is going to be called Blogger. We're going to add some additional styling, but we want to make this center all the time. We can use MX Auto for that as well. And then we also want to set the styling equals, and then we want to create a max width for this, which is going to be 683 pixels. There we go. Right, so let's just try that. Let's grab that, wrap it all up. Let's give this a go. Let's go back into our code. Okay, so you can see that we've changed the size now. You can see that there's a nice little padding on the right-hand side. Let's just drill down a bit. You can see that it's nice and central now. You can see it's also lined up now with the logo, which is all good. And there's a little bit of a change that we need to make, it looks like. But otherwise, it's looking pretty good at the moment. So let's add some styling. Now we're going to do that with in the block. So this is some specific styling here for this block. So we called this blogger. So let's say dot blogger. And then let's go for the H1. So inside a blogger, we've got the H1 tag. So let's style that. So we're going to have a font weight of, this is going to be 700. So we, natural fact here, we can use the class from Bootstrap. It's font weight bold. That's going to give us the bold fonts. We don't need to specify that. We do want some letter spacing, which we can't specify. So 0.6 directly at least. So let's add some of that. And we want to add some padding at the bottom. So we can do this one of two ways, of course. We can add some padding at the bottom. Let's give it one. See what that looks like. So just adding some padding here. Looks not too bad. So let's go for two. That's probably better. Right, so that's the title in place. Doesn't look like we've got to do much here with the admin, other than maybe make it a little bit gray. So let's just add the, remove it. Let's zoom in here and let's add the class here. We're going to add text muted. Oh, what's happening here? Okay, so text muted, and I think that's going to be the same for the date. So let's just add that in date. Let's check that out. Okay, and then the post title, or the subtitle. So the subtitle we're going to also have as text muted. So we add that in, and then it's going to have a font size of 4. There we go. So that pretty much solves that. So we're probably going to need a little bit more padding maybe between that and the subtitle. So let's add some padding there. So font size, padding bottom, let's add 3. Maybe a little bit more. 4. So we're just adding the padding between the text here and the text here. Okay. That's probably looking a little bit better. So that's pretty much all we're going to do here at this point. You can see there's a little bit more that we need to do, but we're going to now focus in on incorporating Markdown. So this is our text at the moment. Now, what we can do is go into the Django admin and we can add and change this text. And pretty much all that we can really do here is that we can add maybe a line break. Now, what if we wanted to, for example, incorporate images and maybe other types of text, headings, for example? It's very hard at this point to do that here. So by incorporating a Markdown tool, we're going to be allowed to add some additional metadata here to create titles, to create other elements. And then we can utilize that because behind the scenes, it will create different tags, H1 tags, H2 tags, and so on. And then we can go ahead and style the text. So we're going to do that next in the next tutorial. And then we come back to this to do a little bit more styling so we can actually then style that text within our page.